guys, welcome back to another edition of the Gr3-7 videos. You know what? With the change in lockdown regulations, I can actually shoot this video live from the Jubilee building. So you know what? I'm gonna go do that. Stay tuned for more. Guess where I am? That's right, folks. I kept my promise. We're at Jubilee Center in OBS. Sorry, I can't go to the city, but I should visit the city sometime. We're about to go inside. I just had my temperature checked at the gate. That's gonna be what it's like coming to church. You get your temperature checked now. And now we go inside. Same doors. To hand sanitization, kids. That'll be part of every process. Okay. Welcome back to Jubilee, everybody. Taking a tour of this is where the filming happens. Silence! They're busy prepping for your return on the 11th of October. So they're having lots of fun. They spend way too much time here. They should get lives. But now I'm going to show you where the magic happens. This is where the videos get filmed for Jubilee for every Sunday that goes on YouTube. This is where the filming takes place. As you can see, this is where the worship would happen. There's no equipment there at the moment. That's where worship is. That's where the pastor goes and preaches. That's where the cameras and the lighting is. So that's how we make our YouTube videos for Sunday service. And yeah, this is Jubilee. We can't wait to see you guys again. This is the room 8 storeroom, guys. This is where we keep all the props that we use to play games. These are our duster hockey sticks. These are pool noodles that we just hit each other with, I guess. Here are our cones, table tennis rackets, a bunch of table tennis nets. You guys break them all. That's why we have like 50. So this is where we keep all our supplies. As you can see, there's still a bit of construction going on in the room because we are preparing to go back to in-person meetings and have a session in room 8 again. Guys, we are super excited about this. We know that not everyone can attend, and that's why we will still make sure to produce Sunday videos every week. So if you can't come to church physically, the video will still be there. You can still have an awesome time online, an awesome time with your family, but we will be having a session in room 8 again on the 11th of October, and we look forward to seeing you at Jubilee Center. This is the chairs that we will stack all around. Do you guys remember the foosball table that we have? Say hi, foosball. And then, some of the posters from our Judges series. Oh, don't you just love Nathan's rank? Where is it? 4, he's not that great. Where's the best? Ooh, well done to Othniel. Where's Deborah? She was pretty good too. Yes, my favorite judge. I don't know why I gave Othniel the one. Anyway, room 8 is busy getting prepared. There's still a lot of work to do, but we are gonna have a kids ministry session in room 8 on the 11th of October. Church hasn't stopped, guys. We're not starting church all of a sudden. All we're doing is bringing church back to a building. But the church is wherever you are with the Holy Spirit, because the Bible says we are the church. So church is continuing just like it has been for the past 6-7 months of lockdown. And we're excited to see what new spiritual journey the Lord takes us on, what lessons he has to teach us, and how he's gonna bring us together and closer as a community. All right, that's a bit of a tour of room 8. I am super excited to see you guys again. And I hope you enjoyed today's video. We're gonna be talking about prayer. And it's going to be awesome. My friend Bryony is doing the talk today. My friend Lizzie is doing the memory verse. And before we get into that, it's time to get loose. I have the whole of room 8 to dance in. We're going to have some worship. And we're going to celebrate this mighty God. You don't get that joke, but you will as soon as the worship starts playing. We're going to celebrate this mighty God we serve and sing and dance together. So let's have some worship together, guys. Enjoy.
fail. Your word is stronger. We overcome. Oh, your glory resounds through the age. All saints declaring your great renown. Your kingdom forever.
Mighty God, Mighty Warrior, that was super cool. Guys, I hope you had tons of fun during worship. We're about to go into the memory verse segment. Just before that, I'd like to pray for us. We've had some fun during worship, and I'd like to pray for the rest of this video that God would bless us and the Holy Spirit would teach us what He has in store for us. All right, Lord Jesus, thank you that you love us. Thank you that you love us so much that you gave your life for us, Lord. Thank you that the church hasn't stopped because of lockdown, Lord. We still get to meet. We still get to connect with you, Lord. And no matter what happens, no matter what happens to the buildings around us, Lord, you are always in our hearts, Lord. And you will always be with us because you promised to be. Pray that you'd bless us in this through the rest of this video. Help us to learn about this memory verse. Help us to learn about prayer, Lord, how we can speak to you and engage with you, Lord. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Now, I just did the opening prayer, so that means you guys are going to do the closing prayer.
That means at the end of the talk, it's going to be me again, but I'm going to let you guys do the closing prayer for us. And I'm going to invite you guys to pray and to respond to God based on this talk. I'm super excited for a series on prayer where we just get to talk about talking to our Father and realize what a great blessing it is to talk to God. All right, guys, now we're going to go over to Lizzie for the memory verse. A memory verse I like to call God's phone number, so enjoy.
Hi, everyone. I'm Lizzie, and we're going to be learning a memory verse today. We're going to be learning Jeremiah 33, verse 3, and it goes like this. Call on me, and I will answer you, and tell you great and unsearchable things that you do not know. Now, I've put together some actions for this, and it goes... Call on me, and I will answer you and tell you great and unsearchable things that you do not know. Okay, let's do it together. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Call on me, and I will answer you and tell you great and unsearchable things that you do not know.
Thank you, Lizzie, for that awesome look at Jeremiah 33, verse 3, the memory verse I'm calling God's phone number, where he asks us to pray. Why should we pray? You might wonder. And why should we pray? We go over to Briny to enlighten us. So, Briny, from roommate, from the Blaze Room, I hand back over to you to lead us in a talk on prayer today.
Hi, everyone. My name is Briny, and I am super excited to be talking to all of you today about prayer and why God wants us to pray. Prayer is something that a lot of people find quite difficult because they don't really understand exactly what it is and how easy it is to just pray to God. But it is such an important part of our lives as Christians. Being a Christian means that we have a relationship with God, but we can't just magically keep this relationship going. We have to work at it. We have to spend time with God. And the best way to spend time with God is through prayer. Think about it like this. Think of your friends or family members who you want to keep being friends with. To make sure that you can remain friends with them, you have to spend time with them. You have to hang out with them. You have to chat with them and just spend time with them. And I know that during lockdown, it must have been very, very hard to keep in contact with your friends because you couldn't see them face to face every day. But I'm pretty sure, I know that I did this, is that you guys made extra certain that you would spend time with your friends over the phone or online, making sure that you spoke to them because you knew that if you didn't spend time speaking to them, well then you're not going to have much in common. You're not going to know how to hang out together afterwards. And it's the same thing with God. We can't see God face to face, but we know he's always around and with us. So we need to spend time talking to him and interacting with him so that we can continue our relationship with him. And the thing is, it's not that God is going to stop loving us if we don't spend time with him. He's always going to love us. But it's for us to get to know more about his character and spend more time with him for ourselves. And we can look at the example of Jesus in this. While Jesus was on earth, he spent a lot of time praying to his Father and talking to him as he went around doing his mission with God. And I have a couple of examples of that. So, during Jesus' ministry, he spent a lot of time with crowds, talking to them, preaching to them, healing them, but he needed to spend time alone as well. So in the Bible, it tells us that often Jesus spent time going alone and spending time alone praying with God away from everyone else, just so that he could reconnect with his Father, talk to God, and just kind of get refueled by that. And that's the same thing that we need to do. We need to spend time alone, talking to God, interacting with God, and just being encouraged and refueled by the special time that we have with God. Another example of when Jesus spent time in prayer was just before he was arrested in the Garden of Gethsemane. He knew what was coming. He knew that he was about to be arrested and then crucified. And he really didn't want to die such a horrific death on the cross. So he prayed to God and he asked God to take that away from him. But then after that, he said to God, he said, whatever your will is, let that be done. And I think that's what we also need to do. We spend a lot of time going to God, I know, and asking him for stuff, asking him to do stuff for us. But we need to remember that God's plan for our life is so much more amazing than anything we could ever plan. And so we need to ask God that his will be done in our lives, not our will. Finally, When Jesus was on the cross, he prayed and asked God to forgive those who had sinned against him by putting him on the cross to die. And this is something that is extremely difficult. But we should be praying for others. We should be praying for forgiveness for those who sinned against us. And then we should also just be spending time with God, asking him for things for other people, not just for ourselves. We need to be praying for others around us. Just as God was Jesus' father, so God is our father. And he wants us to spend time with him. Not just turn to him when we have something we want or need, but to share our lives with him, to ask him for things, but also to thank him for the amazing God that he is, and just talk to our amazing Father, the creator of the universe, and the one who loves us so very much.
Thank you so much, Bryony, for that awesome talk on prayer. And guys, I think the best thing to do after a talk on prayer is to respond with prayer. So if you're by yourself, you can pray by yourself. If you're with your family, you can pray as a group. Let's talk to our Father together, guys. We know that our God is the ruler of the universe. We know he's all-powerful, all-knowing, but he's also all-loving. He's our Father who wants us to talk to him. So let's talk to him. Let's tell him the things that scare us. Let's tell him the things that excite us. Let's thank him for what he's given us and ask him for things and remind ourselves of how good he is and how awesome he is. Guys, this is the end of the video for this week. As you know, church services will be going back in some way on the 11th of October. We just want to say that although not everyone can attend, some because of health reasons and some because of the number restrictions, that's still okay because we will still be making online videos every week. So make sure you tune in for those. And we will still be having the occasional Zoom session where we connect as Blaze together. So that should be loads of fun. Make sure you tune in for those. And hopefully we'll have a few more in-person small group events. Have a time where you can go to the park with your small group leaders, have a picnic or play some games. Grade 4 boys, can you imagine going to the park with Josh and David and playing Josh Ball? I don't know sports, but it will be loads of fun, guys. The last thing I want to say is just this. Church isn't starting again. Church never stopped. Nothing can stop the gospel from being shared. Nothing can stop Jesus' love from being shared, guys. Church is continuing, and it's continuing in a building now, but we'll still be continuing online. Because church isn't a building, church is a people group. And that people group is us. We are the church, the Bible says. So guys, let's continue sharing God's love. Let's continue sharing the gospel. Let's continue connecting as church goes on, and we're so excited. We love you all. Bye, guys.